it's great to be back home, beautiful Las Vegas, Nevada. We welcome you inside the sold-out MGM Grand Garden Arena. And tonight's main event promises to be a truly epic matchup. Hi again, everybody. I'm Mike Goldberg. Welcome once again to the Ultimate Fighting Championship. The best strikers, wrestlers, submission artists, they are all set to compete here tonight inside the world. We begin our night with a bantamweight collision between Joseph Benavidez and Antonio Banuelos. Former WEC bantamweight standout Antonio Banuelos brings two big weapons with him into the octagon: brutal ground and pound and incredible cardio. A top contender in the former WEC bantamweight division, Joseph Benavidez is a well-rounded athlete known for his conditioning, speed, and wrestling ability. He'll be looking to take control tonight and make a huge impact inside the octagon. Antonio Banuelos, making his way to the world-famous octagon.
Antonio Banuelos is a cardio machine, Mike. He's got solid wrestling skills and some vicious ground and pound. Look for him to put this fight on the ground and drop bombs.
Antonio Banuelos, ready to throw down and put on a show. Joseph Benavidez, set to enter the world-famous octagon once again.
Benavidez trains with Uriah Faber at Team Alpha Male, and he comes from a very solid wrestling base. He's extremely quick and athletic, and he's proven that he has the cardio to push the pace for a full five rounds.
Joseph Benavidez, fired up and ready to go. Our Tale of the Tape is brought to you by Tap Out, an expression of combat known worldwide, now available at tapout.com. And now with the official introductions of our fighters, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas. And now, it's time to begin our first bout of the evening. Three rounds in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer and a wrestler. He stands 5'3" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Arroyo Grande, California, Antonio Banuelos. And now, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler and a kickboxer. He stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Sacramento, California, Joseph Benavidez. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Herb Dean.
Herb Dean is our referee. Hi again, everybody. Mike Goldberg alongside Joe Rogan, and we are ready for round one.
Are you ready?
Antonio Banuelos, Joseph Benavidez. And here we go.
Come on, let's do it.
Oh, we got tagged to the hook.
Huge left and right.
Those are snapping his head back, Mike.
Joe mixing up his strikes very well. Push kick.
Spinning back kick.
Oh, my goodness. Boom.
He's got the takedown. Moves into half guard here. Very nice.
And right into side control.
Half guard. And back to full guard.
Able to pass to half guard.
Oh, he connected with an elbow. He's got half guard.
He's in the guard now.
Moves into half guard.
Nicely done.
He's in full guard here.
And a half guard. Well over 2 minutes remains in round number one.
Pressure. Full guard.
Half guard.
He's in the full guard here. Half guard.
Pull on the hip, kick him away.
There's a bit of a cut here on Banuelos, Mike.
Stop. Stand up.
Referee's going to stand him up here. Good call.
All right, let's see fight. If it gets a little faster toe-to-toe.
Nice high kick.
Banuelos got hit in the same spot, and that cut is really open now, Mike.
Oh, big kick.
Over the top. Oh, and punishing the midsection. Oh, answered by a big body shot.
Oh,
head kick. Oh. Oh, ducking in and counters that nicely.
Oh, wow. Looping hook there. Beautiful hook. Brutal knees, and again,
relentless takedowns here.
Pushes him off of the feet. Nice head kick.
Oh, spinning back kick. Oh, they're just throwing.
Oh, they're exchanging here.
Round one is in the books.
Man, they really mixed it up in that round, Joe.
Yeah, both these guys are very well-rounded, and they had a chance to show it in there.
Are you paying attention to me? Don't vary from the game plan, right? Throwing that Superman punch, we don't need that. Hey.
Try to spin him around. Don't let your back sit on the cage, okay? Need some more. Bent knees, okay? Getting a little bit high. Get it high in the uppercut.
Let's take a look at the replay of some of the action here, Mike. Here's that unbelievable
Right? You feel more than that guard. Bring out that combat knee, get yourself.
Ariani gets us set for round two.
Are you ready to fight? Are you ready?
Here we go, round two.
Come on, let's do it.
Oh, nice left and a right.
He is getting battered.
Hands up, hands up.
Punch, oh, beautiful hands hook.
Get it back and up, quick and pain.
Working in the clinch, trying to control his...
Oh! Oh, suplex! Very nice. He ate that one.
Pushing his opponent away.
Beautiful. Don't stay in his range.
Just punishing him.
9-2.
Oh, head kick.
What an onslaught of attack here.
Wide base, wide base.
3 minutes remains in the second round.
Got a takedown again. Over under control.
And again.
He loves throwing that punch. Into full guard here. Pushes him off of the feet. Nice right hand. What an exchange here. Nice right hand. Oh, we got tagged to the hook. He's got his back here.
Control the hips. Control the clinch.
He gets a takedown.
Got the over-under here. He's going for the rear naked. He's got the arm under. It's pretty tight. Escaped.
He had his opponent stretched out but could not finish.
Full guard here.
Pushing his opponent away.
He lets him up.
45 seconds remains.
Don't stay in his range.
30 seconds remains in the round. Outstanding takedowns.
Work it now.
Pushes him off of the feet.
That's the end of round number two. Our fighters will move to the third and final round.
I like how they took that fight everywhere in that round, Mike.
Absolutely. Some well-rounded skills shown by each fighter. We have no idea what to expect here in the last round, but I'm looking.
This is the round he's going to break. You hear me? You got to take it to him. You can dunk him and control him. He's going up the cage, okay? You got to come back.
Let's take a look at the replay, Mike. This was an unbelievable suplex. Beautiful technique. And here we see both of these guys do what they do best. Both landing at the...
One quick thing, when you go jab blow, come back with the jab. Don't come back with the hook. He's leaning.
The beautiful Brittany gets us set for round three.
Are you ready to fight? Are you ready?
We are set for the third and final round. The duck and roll and the body shot. Oh, those are vicious.
He's got the clinch. Again, he takes him down.
Pushing his opponent away.
Oh, big shots.
Nice combination.
Good combination.
Nice leg kick. Oh, big head kick.
Nice left hook.
Under 3 minutes now.
And
he's got the takedown. Passes the half guard.
He's in full guard. He passes to half guard.
Able to posh.
Oh, big shot from the top. And that's it.
That's it. It is all over. Now that is what you call ground and pound. Scored as a knockout. Joseph Benavidez with the spectacular finish.
And this is the one that does it. Knocks the mouthpiece out and shuts off the lights. And again, and here's the knockout blow.
What a great job. Right on the button. Here's Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 40 seconds of the third round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Joseph Benavidez.
Joseph Benavidez wins again.
A welterweight matchup between the natural born killer Carlos Condit and Rory McDonald. Our tale of the tape is brought to you by the only motorcycles worthy of being in the octagon, Harley Davidson.
Here you go, guys.
Rory McDonald.
Are you ready?
Carlos Condit. And here we
go. Come on.
Joe Carlos Condit, professional kickboxing experience. He finishes opponents. He's got a lot of knockouts and a lot of submission wins on his resume.
Yeah, very well-rounded and intelligent fighter, capable of knocking guys out or submitting them. Just a real solid threat at 170 pounds.
Right down the middle. One, two, let's go.
Oh, big spinning back fist.
Condit is cut, Mike. Big right hand. Oh, nice counter left hook right there.
Push kick.
Oh, head kick. He gets the clinch here.
Nice body shot.
Joe, clearly the crowd favorite is Carlos Condit.
Punch. Nice left hook.
Superman punch. Oh, big head kick. Huge left and right.
Those are snapping his head back, Mike.
Oh,
looping hook there.
9-2.
Oh,
head.
Oh, big shot. He's down.
Man, those are knockout punches, Joe.
Vicious punches from the. He's looking for a Kimura. I don't think it's tight.
He got out.
And he escapes.
Posture's up. He's in the guard now, trying to utilize the cage to get back to his feet. Just about 1 minute remains in the first round.
Pressure. 45 seconds. Relax here.
And he caught him again.
He's got the guillotine. I don't think it's quite tight enough.
Round one is complete. Man, Joe, the bell may have very well saved him there.
Yeah, that submission was locked in tight. And ending a round in a dominant position like that sends a very strong message to the judges.
Okay, keep him busy.
Find those punches. Hey, and find the knees right after. Get to the body some too, okay? Hey, you want it? You want it? Let's go get it.
All right, let's go to the replay, Mike. This is that huge shot very nearly ended the fight. And this was that punch that was very nearly a knockout.
You can feed him heavy hands for me. Heavy hands for me, all right?
The beautiful Shandella with us tonight.
Here you go, guys. Are you ready? Are you ready?
This is round
Let's
two.
Go,
and
on.
Here we go.
Beautiful hook. Beautiful head kick there. Oh, beautiful hook.
It looks like McDonald is bleeding here too, Joe. Fast hands. Good battle inside. Wow! Knocked him out with the head kick. How good is that? Carlos Condit with the victory.
Yeah, look at this timing. Perfect accuracy, perfect position. And here we see it again.
Good night.
Here we see it again, close up.
Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 1:05 of the second round, declaring the winner by knockout, the natural born killer, Carlos Condit.
Carlos Condit, your winner. A heavyweight collision between Stefan Struve and Alistair Overeem. One of the most powerful and feared strikers of all time, Alistair Overeem has held prestigious world titles in both MMA and kickboxing at the same time. Tonight, this gifted athlete will be looking to showcase his infamous striking skills inside the octagon. One of the tallest men ever to compete in the sport, 6'11" Dutchman Stefan Skyscraper Struve is a Muay Thai kickboxer with lethal submissions. With a jab that seems to reach all the way across the octagon, this giant is a difficult problem for any opponent to solve. His way to the octagon, and he has this crowd fired up.
Alistair Overeem has world champion striking skills. He's competed at the top levels of kickboxing and MMA for years, has savage power, and if he catches you in his guillotine, he can come very close to pulling your head clean off your body.
Alistair Overeem, ready to throw down and put on a big show for this capacity crowd. Stefan Struve, making his way to the world-famous octagon.
Stefan Struve is a towering, almost 7-foot-tall monster with great striking and beautiful submission technique. He uses his height well on the feet and on the ground, and when he wraps one of those long arms around your neck, it's like a python.
Stefan Struve, fired up and ready to go. Our Tale of the Tape is brought to you by Boost Mobile. And now with our official introductions, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a kickboxer. He stands 6'5" tall, weighing in at 255 pounds. Fighting out of Los Angeles, California, the Demolition Man, Alistair Overeem! And now, fighting out of the red corner, This man is a Muay Thai kickboxer. He stands 6 feet 11 inches tall, weighing in at 250 pounds. Fighting out of Beverwijk, the Netherlands, Stefan Skyscraper Struve. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Kevin Mulhall.
Kevin Mulhall, our referee. Mike Goldberg with Joe Rogan, and we are ready to start round one.
Okay, fighters, are you ready?
Alistair Overeem, Stefan Struve. And here we
Let's
go.
Fight.
Just throw it.
Oh, they're exchanging here.
Wow, that right hand. Oh, answered by a big body shot. Oh,
wow. Looping hook there.
Oh,
and nice body shots. Got him clinched up against the fence.
Oh, and punishing the midsection.
Nice right hand.
There's a bit of a cut here on Struve.
Oh, nice combination. A left hook and then an uppercut. Good body shot.
Nice double leg.
Got in half guard. And back to full guard. He's looking for the triangle, Mike. I don't think it's tight.
Wow, great job done defensively.
Big right hand. Looking for mission control. Oh, he's got a triangle. That's a perfect position, Mike. He's got the arm across the...
He's going to transition,
Joe. Transitions to the arm bar. Don't think it's quite tight enough.
He got out.
And he escapes.
Work that wrist control.
He's got half guard. Moves into full mount here. He ate that one.
And again.
He loves throwing that punch.
Final 30 seconds. Non-title fight. Scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Nice right hand. Oh, he's going for an arm bar.
Round one complete.
Aside from that submission attempt at the bell, we really didn't see much from either fighter, Mike.
Well, let's hope that woke these fighters up. Like it woke the crowd up, Joe.
He's not as good as you.
Listen to me. Don't crowd him. Relax. Don't go for the big hook. Use the right hand.
All right, let's go to the replay, Mike. Here we see some beautiful submission defense to get out of that. Now a look at that near submission that was let go. Didn't quite have it locked in. And here's where we see them going toe-to-toe. Super aggressive and picture-perfect technique from both fighters.
I need you to circle left and stay aggressive. Get that leg kick going.
The beautiful Shandella. We are ready for round two.
Okay, fighters, are you ready? Are you ready?
Second round, fight scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Stick to the game
plan. Oh, big left hook.
1-6.
Oh.
2-3-2.
Chuck off. Watch him trying to bait you. Don't throw him on
his back. Wow, that right hand.
Nice head kick.
Let your hands go.
Stuffed.
Don't do anything sloppy.
Nice right hand.
Struve is bleeding bad here. This does not look good.
He caught the kick.
Big right hook.
Oh, that one dropped him.
Boom. It is all over. That is as vicious a display of ground and pound that you and I have seen in a long time.
That was very, very nasty.
Alistair Overeem with the spectacular finish.
Really ruthless performance here. Got on top of him and just hammered him into submission.
Look at it from this angle. And with the official decision, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Kevin Mulhall has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 34 seconds of the second round, declaring the winner by TKO, the Demolition Man, Alistair Overeem.
Alistair Overeem, the winner. It's our co-main event of the evening. A bantamweight collision between Mighty Mouse, Demetrius Johnson, and the California Kid, Uriah Faber. A well-rounded holder of multiple MMA titles, Uriah Faber became a household name by ruling the WEC featherweight division for over 2 years. Athletic and aggressive, the California Kid uses his quickness and his wrestling skills to dominate his opponents. Gifted with tremendous speed and athleticism, Demetrius Johnson was inspired to train in mixed martial arts when he first saw a show called The Ultimate Fighter. He now finds himself inside the octagon, ready to test his skills against the very best in the world. Faber making his way to the octagon, and he has this crowd fired up.
Faber's been one of the premier fighters in the smaller weight classes for years. He was a dominant featherweight champion back in the WEC, great stand-up, and a ton of natural athleticism. He's tough as nails, too, and can fight through tremendous adversity.
Uriah Faber, ready to throw down and put on a big show for this capacity crowd. Demetrius Johnson, making his way to the world-famous octagon.
Demetrius Johnson is a well-conditioned athlete with great technique standing up or on the ground. He's got excellent speed and footwork, and he's great at using that to set up his strikes and his takedowns.
Demetrius Johnson, fired up and ready to go. Our Tale of the Tape is brought to you by Boost Mobile. Once again, with our official introductions for this battle, the veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the co-main event of the evening. Three rounds of fighting in the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a boxer and a wrestler. He stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Sacramento, California. The California Kid, Uriah Faber. And now, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a wrestler and a kickboxer. He stands 5'3" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Parkland, Washington, Demetrius Mighty Mouse Johnson. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Josh Rosenthal.
Josh Rosenthal, our referee. Mike Goldberg alongside Joe Rogan. We are ready to get things started. Uriah Faber, Demetrius Johnson. And we are underway.
Keying away. Big right hand. Nice right hand. Nice left hook. Oh, big kick. Great combinations. I like the way he's mixing these up. He's got a hold of his neck, Mike. He's looking for a guillotine. He's got an arm in, full guard. This is very tight, Mike.
And it is all over. Submission victory. Guillotine choke. Man, that was deep. Uriah Faber finishes the fight.
As soon as he has that full guard locked in, that's a ton of leverage, and he just squeezes on it right there.
And there you see the tap.
Here we see it one more time.
The veteran voice of the Octagon, Bruce Buffer, has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Josh Rosenthal has called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 55 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out due to a guillotine choke, the California Kid, Uriah Faber.
Uriah Faber, the winner. Light heavyweight showdown between John Jones and Vitor, the Phenom Belfort. Known around the world for his dizzying hand speed, Vitor Belfort is a jiu-jitsu expert with some of the best boxing in the division. An experienced veteran with an impressive octagon career, the Phenom is always capable of ending a fight with a highlight reel flurry of punches. John Jones skyrocketed to popularity when he gave UFC fans a series of spectacular victories. He's established himself as a respected, well-rounded fighter, capable of delivering both knockout shots and expert submissions. Vitor Belfort, making his way to the world-famous octagon.
Vitor is primarily known for his blinding punching speed. He has explosive striking and a lot of impressive knockouts. He's got a great amount of experience in the sport and has been facing championship-level competition since the late 90s.
Vitor Belfort, ready to throw down and put on a show. John Jones, set to enter the world-famous octagon once again.
John Jones is a very powerful wrestler with some of the most ruthless elbow strikes we've ever seen. He is an unpredictable fighter on the feet, not afraid to throw crazy, spinning, high-risk shots, and he attacks from all kinds of angles.
John Jones, fired up and ready to go. Tale of the Tape is brought to you by UFC Store. The sport lives here. And now, with the official introductions, the veteran voice of the Octagon, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And now, live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! Three rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division.
Introducing first.
Fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a mixed martial artist. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada. Vitor the Phenom! And now, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist. He stands 6 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Endicott, New York. Ladies and gentlemen, he is the current UFC light heavyweight champion of the world, John Bones Jones. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of this contest is Mario Yamasaki.
Mario Yamasaki, our referee. Mike Goldberg alongside my partner Joe Rogan. And we are ready to get this fight started. Vitor Belfort, John Jones, round one is underway.
Over the years, so much has been said, so much has been written about Vitor Belfort, the Phenom. But he truly defines explosiveness.
Yes, he does, Mike. He comes out of the gate firing on all cylinders, and if you get caught with one punch, guaranteed there's 100 more coming very quickly your way.
And the chanting switches to Vitor Belfort,
trying to close the distance.
Oh, to the midsection. Spinning back fist. Big connection.
Oh, big right hand. He's down.
He got tagged there, but it looks like he's recovered.
And the crowd again chanting for the Phenom, Vitor Belfort.
Oh, answered by a big body shot. Push kick.
Oh, and punishing the midsection. That's a heavy spinning back fist. That did a ton of damage.
Wow, that right hand.
And again.
Over and over again.
And again. Man, they're pummeling back.
He's hurt badly. He's down. Oh, but he recovers. He is getting battered.
Just over a minute remains. Getting in tight, using the clinch. Just about 1 minute remains in the first round.
What a great display of hand fighting. And fans at home, you've got to realize that these men are really working to get to a dominant position.
He trips, boom, got him to the ground.
Nicely done. Half guard. Passes to side control.
Oh, another one.
Another big strike.
Oh, he's going for an armbar.
Joe, this building is electric. What a classic matchup. Our first round is in the books. What a great round of action, Joe.
Yeah, both fighters came out aggressive, and that was a beautiful submission attempt at the end. A few more seconds, and I think we'd have seen a tap out.
Take a couple deep breaths. Look me in the eye. He's got nothing for you. Straight punches with him. Let's start hitting those legs a little bit.
Let's take a look at the replay of some of the action here, Mike. This is that huge shot, very nearly ended the fight. And here's that punch that hit right on target. And here was that nasty counterstrike, just so perfectly timed.
Hey, look it. Just score. All you need to do is score. You score with that kick.
The beautiful Shandella Powell.
Here we go, guys. Are you ready? Are you ready?
Set for round two.
Let's
this
go.
Fight's scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds.
Make them reach it and make them pay. Don't do anything sloppy.
Oh, big spinning back fist.
Working your angles.
Oh, spinning back kick. Oh, they're just throwing.
Oh, they're exchanging here.
They clinch.
Stay busy.
Nice knee to the body. Big right hand.
Relentless takedowns here.
Pushes him off with the feet. He decides to let him up.
Take your time. Nice and relaxed.
Teeing away.
Oh, head kick. Nice right hand.
Look at that uppercut.
Work that body. Body shots when you're in that tight. Let's cut him. We gotta cut him.
Let him see the uppercut.
And another takedown.
Perfect.
Pushing his opponent away.
Oh, he lets him up.
Good counter though, Joe.
Sometimes shorter, quicker punches. Oh, he got hurt. He's down.
Oh, with the elbow. Oh, my goodness. Sitting back fist.
He's out.
Oh, he buried him there, Joe.
Oh, that's it.
This fight is over. John Bulge Jones.
Yeah, let's look at it again.
There was certainly bad intention when he throws this one.
Let's see it one more time. He just nails him with that.
That's a highlight reel knockout right there, Joe.
Here we see it again. Excellent timing on the button.
And with our official decision, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes 38 seconds of the second round, declaring the winner by knockout, John Bones Jones.
Jones reigns supreme. The capacity crowd here tonight witnessed another great showing from some of the UFC's best fighters. For my partner Joe Rogan and all of us at the Ultimate Fighting Championship, Mike Goldberg saying so long until next time, we see you right back here inside the Octagon.